This group's rhetorical skills are about to be put to the test as we give them only 1 minute as a group to tackle each of this week's on-the-clock topics. So up first, could the exodus from Arizona be starting? A new Arizona Republic, that's a newspaper, story points out many schools in the Grand Canyon State are losing students as families take flight in the face of the controversial new immigration law. The paper even talked to one family that is considering relocating here, Marisa, to New Mexico. That's one family, so we don't want to make too much of it. But is this a possibility? Could you see this happening?
Of course it's a possibility, and we don't know what kind of numbers we're talking about.
Right.
We don't have any idea. And I think it's important to note, too, that there are going to be families leaving Arizona who are not just undocumented immigrants, but citizens who don't want to deal with all of the stress of having local law enforcement check immigration status for every infraction, including municipal ordinances. If your weeds are too high, they can check on your immigration status. And that's, you know, that's intense. Phoenix is estimating a $90 million loss next year, and that's just from service revenues.
Gonna work these guys in.
Am I gonna sound too flip if I say we would like the $90 million, please? I think that we don't yet know, to follow up, we don't yet know what the economic impact is gonna be on Arizona or on us, and whether we might, in fact, benefit.
Sure. 10 seconds.
Words, A Day Without a Mexican. It's a movie. Yeah. People should watch that. If there's any doubt about the impact of illegal immigrants on the economy.
Interesting. I'm going to hold you on that one, Jim. Now, Governor Richardson says the State Film Museum will suspend operations at the end of the month, saving the state about $177,000 in salaries and other expenses. The museum has been at the center of several media reports because it has no exhibits, Jim, and two employees. So does this prove that there's still some fat to be cut away? Why didn't this happen
any
before?
Reason. What an example why people are mad. We had a woman making, what, $90,000 a year. Mm-hmm. She's a political appointee, politically connected family, running a museum that doesn't exist, and now she's going to retire. Mm-hmm. This is the sort of outrage, I think, that is helping Susana Martinez.
I think the PIO there was making some serious dough, too. I'm not sure PIOing what. What do you think?
Well, I think overall it's a good move to probably shut that position down overall. You know, there's probably other places you could trim the fat on the budget.
Marisa, what do you think?
I think that you hit a point where you either have to give something programming funding and, you know, operational funding, or you have to end it. So you either have to fully fund your idea and get it off the ground, or you have to cut your losses.
Good point. Going to hold you there, Sophie. In a related story, the New Mexico Independent has an update recently on the state's controversial film incentive program. Our friend Trip Jennings reports the state has paid out more than $180 million over the last 3 years through the program. Sophie, pardon me, during the governor's race, we talked about that there's the potential that this could be a make or break year for the incentive program.
Correct.
Meaning depending who gets in office. Mm-hmm. And so there's people that have a lot of heartburn with this, but there's the other side of it too, that people say it has to happen.
Well, and when we focus on jobs in this state, this is an example that we've been talking about for a number of years of a program that does seem to have generated significant job growth within an industry that we would like to keep. Mm-hmm. And so it will be interesting to see whether this comes up as part of the jobs discussion.
Mm-hmm. Thinking ahead, if Ms. Martinez gets in, honestly, is this something that's going to get looked at with a very hard eye here?
Well, I would expect that for anybody who's in there, whether it's Senator Martinez, and when this does get looked at, there's going to be some explaining to do to the local economies, because this is also helping local economies in terms of rental of properties and purchasing of materials and also job growth, and it builds the tax base also in a local community when there are these companies filming out in rural areas.
Sure.
The benefits are very much in doubt, and they're being debated. The State Investment Council is already re-examining the film industry credit. They've pulled back considerably, and the $181 million in credits that we gave, multiply that by 16 times. That's how much economic activity and tax revenue it took for the state to come up with $181 million to give to Hollywood.
Interesting. A feel-good story, however, to finish. From the local theater community, Musical Theater Southwest, as you saw, lost all of its costumes and props in a horrific fire last month. Many of the other theater companies, however, have jumped into the group's aid, offering rehearsal space, supplies, even cash, Marisa. Does this prove, I think I know the answer here, but does this prove a point about how cohesive the...
I love how you called it a feel-good story.
Well, you know what I mean.
The first
part's not so good. Yeah. Right, exactly. But there's a rally going, a rally to the cause. This is how the arts community rolls here, isn't it?
That it's is how arts communities have to roll, I think, everywhere, because they are not often big or well-funded communities. Yeah. So you have to help each other out. And Neil Patrick Harris, Doogie Howser, is talking about donating some money to Musical Theater Southwest. Yeah. It's not sure yet how much, but it's a big name.
He was on their stage as a young man, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was in Peter Pan in the 80s. Yes.
I love your research abilities. Nobody else in this town knows that, I bet. Sophie, what do you think?
You know what? It's hard not to kind of love Neil Patrick Harris as a native son, and he's going out there and doing great for us, and it's nice to see him remembering the city like
that.
Did
you see his turn on Glee a couple of weeks ago? He was a hoot. He is so funny.
And he's also now, I mean, just to sort of, I'm sure he's cringes when he hears Doogie Howser talk, because he's done a lot of other things, but How I Saved Your Mother, funny show.
Right, right.
Support these folks. Go see their next production of Thoroughly Modern Millie starting July 16th at the African American Cultural Center at the State Fair, and show your support for a wonderful group of people.
Good job. That's all the time we have for this week's show, but remember, the conversation continues throughout the week on Facebook and Twitter, and you can also send us an email at infocus@kname.org. We'll be back with more discussion and debate next week on New Mexico in Focus, a show that's informed, involved, and in-depth. We'll see you then.